thank you for tuning in today. This is The Gifted Ones, and I'm your host, Liz Throp. And today's vibrational boost comes from our expert, Dr. Tracy Kennedy. Our topic today is empaths and what it means to be one. Our expert guest, Tracy Kennedy, will certainly help us unravel what it means to be an empath. Dr. Kennedy has a master's in sociology from York University, a PhD in sociology from University of Toronto. She is an empath, psychic medium, Reiki master, registered yoga teacher, published author, public speaker, spiritual educator, and owner of the Spiritual Spa and Shiva Gyan Yoga in Niagara Falls, Canada. I hope I said that right. She has also taught essential practices for empaths in Lilydale, New York. Welcome,
Thank
Tracy.
You so much. Thanks for having me.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I'm so excited. This is a topic that's a little close to me.
Absolutely.
I am too an empath, so it's been something I've found challenging my whole life. So
when
I discovered you and your insight to it, I had to have you on the show, obviously. So can you please describe to everyone watching what it means to be an empath?
Absolutely. So I think the first thing I want to say is that the term empath gets confused with compassion and sympathy and even feeling empathy. And with those terms, you're feeling something for other people, right?
Yeah.
You know, we're compassionate for people who are struggling. We can sympathize sometimes, you know, and have empathy for somebody if we've gone through it ourselves. So you're feeling something for someone, and you're conscious of it. When you're an empath, you feel with the person, and you might not know that you have that ability to do that. So this is a very much an embodied experience, not something that you might be conscious of when you're feeling things. And so that makes it very different. It's like a first person experience as opposed to third person, you know, in the bleachers type of thing, watching what's happening with your loved ones. So you're in it. And I mean, many people don't realize that they have this ability. And so what happens, of course, with your mood fluctuations and your emotions, you know, kind of roller coastering, people think that, what's wrong with me?
Yeah,
where's this coming from? Well, I was fine when I left the house, and now I'm at the grocery store, and I'm all agitated, and then, okay, now I'm in aisle 5, and I'm feeling better, and it's so...
That's so true.
Yeah, but it's important to understand that you are feeling with the person. You're not feeling for.
Right. So what would be some clues to help someone understand? Like, what would be, you know, an empath is somebody who, and then
well,
go ahead.
I used to cry at Kodak commercials when I was a kid.
Oh, all the time. I still do.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, I think these are the folks that had a lifetime of, why are you so sensitive? Stop being oversensitive. Stop overreacting, you know, and all of those cues that people say to you with respect to your emotions. I think for me, the roller coastering, like I said, you know, one minute you're fine, the next minute you're not, you know, and you're logically trying to figure it out. I'm good.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
this is kind of bothering, but it's not bothering me the way that I'm feeling right now.
Yeah.
I would say in terms of clues, being very connected to nature and needing to hermit yourself, to have some alone time and, you know, to kind of debrief and to find yourself again in all that emotion that's swirling around you. So, you know, there's a lot of different things that can give you a clue, but mostly the intense feeling emotions, you know, and empaths hyper emote. You know, it's not we don't just get a little ticked off. It's like if we're in a rage and can put our foot through the wall. And that's scary for some people. But on the other hand, then we can also, when we're happy and joyful, good heavens, we're in an amazing state of grace and beauty when we're in those high vibration emotions, right? So
I always tell my clients that I suspect are empath. I ask them a series of questions. So I'll say, how do you feel about going out in public, for example?
Yep.
Do you mind going shopping? And empaths typically don't like to shop.
And we love online shopping.
Right? the other question I'll ask them is, when you're out in public, do random strangers often
seek
you out? Right?
Absolutely.
And they just want to hone in on you and ask you personal questions, right?
Do you know why they do that?
Why do they do that?
Because subconsciously, they know that when they share that story with you, you're going to get it because you feel it.
Right.
So there's that everybody wants to be understood and heard.
Yes.
And empaths hear you because they feel you.
I love it.
And this is a constant thing. You can be at the grocery store and the person behind you starts telling you their life story. You're at the bus stop, whatever, you know, and
it's true.
I embrace that. At first it was a little, well, I don't know what, why people
Well, as empaths we do,
Absolutely.
Right? Because we're forgiving of anybody and we have no filter. So it's like, it doesn't matter what you say to us, we're going to accept you no matter what you say. That's the beautiful thing about being empathic. Yeah. Yeah. Another thing I tell people is, you have zero tolerance for lying on any level.
Yes.
Like there's just zero tolerance. You can, people, they get, let people get away with a lot of stuff, empaths, right? Mm-hmm. So they'll be, you know, somebody who gets run over a lot and emotionally run over. But if you lie to them, they'll cut you off.
Yeah.
Right.
And I will say that empaths are very good at sniffing out fakes and liars.
Yes.
Okay. So, you know, you might be introduced to your friend's buddy Bob, and Bob's great. I love Bob. You're like, something's not right with
something's
Bob. 6 months later, something's not right with Bob.
Exactly.
So my motto or mantra as an empath, if it doesn't feel right, it's not right.
That's right. Beautiful. Beautiful advice.
And you can't second guess that or logic it to death in the head. If it doesn't feel right, it's not
right. Just trust it.
Yep.
Trust it. Now, you've written a book called, and I love the title of this, hashtag I feel you, Life as an Empath. And this is due to be released this year. What can our viewers expect to learn from this book?
I'm very excited about this book.
Yeah, me
I have
too.
To say. It's been many years in the making. I started teaching about empaths 6 years ago, so I've got lots of, I have lots of insight I'd like to share. Some of it is personal experience, obviously, in sharing my life, but also I'm going to be starting some focus groups and interviews with some empaths to, you know, to hear everybody's story. So
awesome.
The book, is about, how you would experience, what kind of things do we experience as empaths? So I go over different types of things. You know, it's not just people and individuals. We certainly feel places and spaces, right? You know, groups, of people, but even things like plants and animals, trees, crystals, rocks, all of those experiences that you can have and interact with as an empath. So I kind of go over that because it is a continuum of experience. I kind of see it as on a spectrum. You know, some empaths might, I don't want to say might just feel people because that's pretty, you know, it's heavy.
Yeah, it's heavy
but,
enough.
But there are empaths that can feel everything.
Yeah.
You know, that they can tell you exactly what cycle the moon is in, what sign it's in, because they can feel that, you know, cosmic energy.
Yeah.
So there's that so that people can understand the depth of the experience. And then I talk about how do you navigate it? You know, what do you do with, you know, hi, I'm a walking satellite dish and
exactly.
and I need
it's
to do my stuff. I need
it.
To get my groceries done. I need to do my stuff. So, you know, how to navigate that, how to work with that. You know, looking at things like you really have to understand who and what you are and what you feel, that know thyself.
Yeah.
You know, tools like different grounding stuff and different filters and boundaries and things like that. And then how to flourish.
Beautiful.
So how do we use this beautiful gift that we have to not only for ourselves, but for others?
Beautiful.
You know, and so that I'm going to leave it at that.
Yeah, I love it.
Little teaser.
I can't wait
Thank
till it
you.
Comes out. When it does come out, we'll put the link at the bottom of this.
Wonderful.
At this YouTube.
I'm still working on release dates because it'll be astrological.
Of course it will.
What the
of
date is and you
I
know how
it.
That works.
Okay. All right. Well, they'll be the first to know here.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you did mention grounding.
Mm-hmm.
Can you describe to our viewers how best to ground themselves? What does that mean for somebody who's never heard that term before?
Empaths carry a lot of energy. So think about Beavis and Butthead on Red Bull.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're like, you could be really wired. There's a lot of nervous energy in the body. Yeah. It affects the central nervous system. So we want to release that. We don't want to house that in the body. We want to release that. We want to give ourselves a tether, that grounding feeling. Think about the three prong plugs in the wall.
Right.
We need that third grounder wire, you know, to ground that energy. So planting yourself. That term planting yourself. I like to connect with the earth. Empaths have a really strong connection with Mother Earth. We feel the magnetic energy. And so I tap into that.
Yeah.
It plants me. I have a visual where I go right to the core. energetically out through your feet, so like tree roots, and I just plant myself. And then I don't feel like the helium balloon that's kind of,
yes.
la, 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 you know, at least I'm here and tethered.
Yeah.
So that gives me a very solid feeling rather than scattered and flighty and too much caffeine or energy. But that also gives me some plumbing, some spiritual plumbing.
I love it.
Because now I can release that energy through those roots out the bottom of my feet going into the earth and just flush it out.
Perfect.
And I can easily say that with an intention. Okay. Anything that's, you know, let's get rid of this stuff. You know,
yeah.
Say it simple. It doesn't have to be complicated. Any
yeah.
vibration that's not high, anything that's not love and light, out through the feet. And then I pull up through the earth too.
Yeah.
So that I can recharge myself and have that grounding magnetic energy.
Beautiful.
So that's the grounding.
You know, basically
aspect.
What I do, same as you, but I imagine those roots like cutting through the core of the earth, like
mm-hmm.
A hot knife through butter.
Yeah.
So it's easy and effortless. And that's,
yeah.
I loved how you said that. It doesn't have to be complicated
no.
or difficult.
Yeah.
You just have to use your imagination.
Yeah.
And I literally make my way with those roots. And I think of just one root. I don't spread it out.
Right.
One root, yep. one thick root. As soon as I hit the core of the earth,
yeah.
I wrap it around.
Yeah.
And I think of, remember those little elastic band balls we used
yes,
to make as children?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
For anybody that's younger, probably won't know, but we used to make these balls. I think of it like
yeah,
that. And so
yeah.
I am really tethered to the earth.
Yes.
And I do that first thing in the morning
mm-hmm.
because of what we do for a living.
Absolutely.
It's important to ground
yeah.
yourself. But just
yeah.
for the average person, grounding and meditation,
yep.
huge.
And in even the food that you eat.
Yes.
So, you know,
yeah.
When you're packing your lunch, maybe, you know, get those root vegetables in there. And,
yes.
you know, there's a lot of different things. You can use crystals to help you ground with that energy. There's lots of, yeah.
Yeah, crystals are amazing.
Yeah. And in terms of mediating that energy and, I mean, being mindful that you can set your filters and boundaries. People call it protection.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't always like to use the word protection because it puts us in a fear space. Oh my God, I'm under attack. I gotta
right.
put my, and I don't want
right.
to live in a fear space. Right. So I want to be in control. If I feel something wonky doodle, I'm like Star Trek. Shields up, here we go.
I love it.
You know,
yeah,
and
yeah.
and that gives me a boundary, a filter. I program it. Only love and light's allowed in because I want to feel the good stuff.
Yeah.
I don't filter that out.
Yeah.
I want to feel your good stuff because that's, you know,
that's
helps
me.
That's
what we do. That's
yeah.
what we do.
So, but anything that's not high vibration or love and light, it just bounces off.
So one of the tips I use, just so, because we're on the topic, I imagine it like we are tethered by an imaginary umbilical cord.
Yeah.
And I plug into your belly button. So the minute I walk into any space, mm-hmm. like walking into this building, I tethered into every person here. Until I cut the cord
mm-hmm.
and I make little scissors with my finger and I cut the cord. That way I'm staying protected you know, however we want to put it. If you're shopping and that's overwhelming to
mm-hmm.
you, I find cutting the cord before you even leave your car
yeah.
makes it so much easier to do that process,
absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
So there's tons of different ways
mm-hmm.
in order to, I love your shields up.
Yep.
And again, it's imagination. It's
yep.
all about imagination,
yep.
folks, right?
Yeah. In those times where it's heavy, like if I'm at I go to a lot of concerts. I love,
yes.
I'm a metalhead, you know.
Yeah,
so, but sometimes
that's
that energy,
along.
That's why we get along. Sometimes the energy of whatever grocery stores or concerts can be, and you know, you kind
yeah.
of start to feel that shrinking in.
Yeah.
And that's when I go from being on the defense to being on the offense, and I shoot out my love lasers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Love it.
To
yeah.
exude that energy out so that it doesn't come to me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because sometimes there's a lot of energy, and you know, you can kind of feel, oh, I feel that on the aura. That's
yeah.
it's like, no, I'm gonna blast out
yeah.
love and light.
Beautiful.
And I find that that really helps. That makes me active in the process.
Perfect.
And nothing comes through that love.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. Now, I always describe to my clients that being an empath is like having a superpower.
Yeah.
So can you share with those watching right now why being sensitive is a positive and not a negative?
Absolutely.
Because you did allude to that at the beginning, that we often think we're too sensitive, right?
Yeah. Well, and part of that is socialization.
Right.
I mean, we are in the modern age, the rational age, and emotions are not acceptable. They're not. They're messy. There's
yeah.
There's a whole sociological thing on that.
Yeah.
That we can talk about another time. But
yeah.
but understand that, you know, how we feel and what we feel, a lot of that is taught to us. You know, in terms of how you're supposed to react to things you know, socially or culturally, and that doesn't always resonate within when you're an empath, right?
Right.
But as a superpower, well, we radar one, we're the walking satellite dish. But what this means is our own radar for ourself. So we can have that, you know, something's not right here. Bob doesn't feel right. Sorry for all the Bobs out there.
I know, poor Bob.
It's just a name I always use.
I know.
You know, but so there, you have that internal radar system in place already. Being an empath, I think, can be an absolutely beautiful experience because we can experience the world with our emotions. And again, that notion of hyper-emoting and feeling everything intensely, that means when I'm in a state, like I said earlier, of joy and grace, that I can sit there in that energy of that higher power, that to me is huge, because there are so many people walking around very numb and not
so
feeling,
true.
Not expressing, you know,
repressing.
Repressing. And that's not great. And for yourself, of course, as an empath, we can manifest things for better or for worse.
Yes, that's
right?
Huge.
Absolutely. If you can feel it, you manifest it. So a lot of the, you know, New Age folks talk a lot about, you know, verbal stuff. Say it, you know, the affirmations and stuff.
Yes.
Empty words are empty words if there's no oomph behind it,
yeah,
no emotion.
That's right.
So we need to feel it.
Yeah.
Same with prayer. We need to feel that.
Yeah.
And Greg Braden talks a lot about that, which I'm absolutely into. So you can create your world. What do you want
sure
to create?
Can.
That's the big question. What do you want to create?
Yeah.
Right? So you create
I manifested
your world.
This.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So with respect to others, because empaths do have a strong call to service, you'll see a lot of empaths as social workers, cops, paramedics, nurses, anywhere where people are struggling. Oh, yep. There's the empath. Let me help you.
Yeah.
So huge on service. But they are the service workers. You know, they because we can connect with people, you know, so many nurses telling me their stories of people who aren't able to articulate their needs. It's okay. I feel what you need.
Yeah.
I feel
so
what
true.
You need.
So true.
So in that sense, that ability to support the random guy in the Tim Hortons that just told me the life story, I feel you, I'm here for you.
Yeah.
You know, that supporting of our community, but also collectively, because we can generate a lot of positive energy and really exude that. And I think that's, we shine light.
Yeah,
you know,
we do.
We
feel like it's part of our plan. We can't help it.
Yeah.
But to shine our
absolutely.
Light. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Yeah. But I will tell you that empaths need to remember that service includes service to self.
Huge.
Self-service and, you know, serving others, because remember the mask on the plane, you put your own mask on first and then the mask of the person beside
you. That's a beautiful way to put
it. You know,
and I love it.
You have to take care of self.
Well, thank you so much for sharing your wisdom today, Tracy. Remember, folks, stay grounded. And most importantly, you've got the power. Have a blessed and abundant day.
Thank you.